哎，你知道那个吗？我啥意思？
为什么有两个的感觉呀、啊？好神奇啊！这是我在那个视频是吧？
这不是你这个手机的视频啊？
那我就关掉这个。
嗯，哈利波，
哈利波，马哈拉，您能说两句吗？我们看一下能不能扩音。
嗯，宽一点。
好了，
可以了。好了，
大家能听到。今天很高兴能够邀请到。在主题前端的徒步的写的生日邀请到能听到 Maharaj 来跟我们做讲课，让我们热烈的欢迎 Maharaj 的到来。
有人说声音可能小了，你接一下音箱。这个声音我估计不孤单。
我们开始，可以吗？
好的。
Om Magyana Chamarandasya Gyananjana Shalakaya Chaksurun Militanyena Tismay Shri Gurave Namaha Nama Om Vishnu Padaya Krishna Prestaya Bhutale Shrimati Bhaktivedanta Swaminiti Namane.Namaste Sarasati Devi Gauravani Pracharine Nirvishesha Shunyavadi Paschacha Desatarine Vanchakaupatarubhyascha Kripasindubhayevacha Patitanam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavibhyo Namo NamahaJai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shri Vasadi Gaur Bhaktavinda Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare 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 Rama Hare Rama 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 Hare Hare So today'sOf course, the auspicious day of the appearance of Lord Nityananda. So we're going to recount some of the pastimes of Lord Nityananda. So Lord Nityananda was born in a place called Ekachakra. Ekachakra is...Some distance away from Mayapur, and it's in the place which that area is called Radha Desh. So this is a place where the Ganga does not flow. There's no Ganga there.So, different from Mayapur. So, Lord Nityananda was born in the... He was the son of a very devoted Brahmin named Hare Pandit. And his mother was called Padmavati.
Padmavati
had the couple as well as Lord Nityananda, they had another son who was called Bankarai. So it was the brother of Nityananda.
Oh, 他们还有另外一个儿子啊，叫 Bunker Roy， 是 Nityananda 的兄弟。
So.
我要看一下。
The name Banka means somebody who's curved in three places, just like Krishna is called Tribanga. Tribanga. So Banga means curve.
Banka 的意思呢是曲线的意思，就好像 Krishna 有一个名字叫三度曲线，就是 Krishna 有三度曲线，他的这个形体有三度曲线一样。
So Banka refers. We can't have this all the time. You got to do something about the system there, the echo.
Oh, there's echo. 有回音.
Yes. What is 声音? 回音.
有回音. Okay. Is it all right now or still
echo? Yeah, it seems to be better now. Yeah.So, Banka, that's referring to Krishna. The name Banka refers to Krishna, and Raya refers to Radharani. So when both are combined together, you have Banka Rai.
It is the
So the two brothers were living there in Ekachakra, and they used to have many pastimes with all the young boys there in the village. So there was a very interesting pastime took place. They used to go into the jungle. And one time when they went...
Raya and Banka is Krishna's name. Raya is Balarama's name.所以Nityananda 和 Banka Raya 他们在Ekachakra 有很多和其他的男孩子们有很多这个一起玩耍，有很多逍遥时光在那里上演。
So it happened one day. No, there's 回音，这个回音。
哦，是不是因为蓝
音？那翻译的声音好小。
哦，要不把这个关掉试试？
没有，没，但其他人听不到呀。你把那开多远？到那边去。没有，他们是上不了。没下的人不会用他们的手机。高人快。不好意思，现在回音还有吗？
我们看，我不知道。Okay, so the two brothers, Gauranga, Lord Chaitanya, and his brother Bankam Rai, they were going into the jungle one day, but they got told by the villagers. They said, "Hey, don't go there. There's a big poisonous snake there."And that snake is devout. It's eating people, and people go there. They never come back. They get eaten by the snake. So don't go.
翻译的声音听不懂，
听不到啊！翻译的声音，我这应该对哪里啊？
应该对手机
对
吗？
不是手机。好的。
Okay, so Nityananda he didn't listen to what the villagers said, and he and his brother they both went into the jungle.
那么Nityananda他没有去听这个警告，所以这两兄弟呢，他们就去到了丛林。吸音口在哪里？吸音口。 在这里是吧？
So in the jungle, there was this big tamala tree. The tamala tree, you know, the very black color trees.
在这个丛林里面呢，是有黑色的一棵树。这个树呢是tamala 树。
And when the two brothers came walking into the jungle, then the big snake came out, and it was raising its hooves, and it was hissing like the sound snakes make.
你要不学好呢，是怎样？
当他们两兄弟呢，去到，大家静音好吗？不要，大家静音啊，现在。当这个两兄弟他们走到丛林里去的时候呢，就有一个像大蟒蛇一样的，就一个大的蛇就出来了，然后他就把他的这个蛇的头啊，马上就挺起来，然后吐信在那里吐信子。
But Nityananda, he was. Oh, what is going on there today?
Maharaj, 是有回音吗 ？Still some.Problem? You mean the echo?
Okay, Nityananda wasn't afraid at all, and he raised his hands and he said to the snake, "Oh, you wicked fellow, don't stay here."
Ah, then Nityananda 一点都不怕，看到这个大蟒蛇，他说，哎呀，你这个罪恶的东西，别在这儿。
He said, don't, you just stay there under the tree, don't come forward, don't come any closer, just stay where you were under the tree.
你就好好在树下待着，别从那个地方离开。
So the snake stopped, and then Lord Nityananda said to the snake, he said, why are you killing and eating all the innocent people?
然后呢，这个蛇听了主尼天南的话，他就在那儿停住了，在树下停住了啊。然后，主尼天南的就问这条蛇了：“你为什么去伤害那些无辜啊？把他们给吃了呀
？”So Lord Nityananda is none different from Lord Balarama, and Lord Balarama has his expansion as Anantashesha, who is the king of all snakes.
那么主尼天南达呢是巴拉拉玛的扩展，而巴拉拉玛呢，他是阿南塔舍舍，他是所有蛇的头领，所有蛇的王。
No, I said Balarama's expansion is Anantashesha.
Balarama 的扩展是阿南塔舍舍。
Yeah, and so Lord Balaram is not different from Nagaraj.The king of all snakes.
Balarama, 他和 Nagaraj, 也就是蛇所有蛇的头领蛇王没有区别。
我
刚
才是把那个手拟出来。
啊？什么？
我也听不懂。
听不到啊。大家能听到吗
？The Lord Nityananda. Oh, there's still some weighing. The echo.
回音是
不是 ？Lord, when Lord Nityananda told the snake to stop, the snake stopped, and Lord Nityananda asked the snake. Lord Nityananda, I said, why are you doing this? And then the snake.Related the history, what this history was from the Dwapara Yuga, from the previous Yuga.
那么，所以呢，就是这条蛇，听了主尼天丹的话之后呢，他就开始讲述他他自己的故事。这个故事是在 Dwapara Yuga 发生的。
So this big poisonous. Oh, Krishna.The big poisonous snake said, in the Dwapara Yuga, after the Pandavas had been staying in the house of a Brahmana, they wandered in this jungle.
在 Dwapara Yuga, Pandava, 他们呢就是说 曾经在这个丛林里面徘徊。
Previously, the Pandavas had been staying in the house of lack, which had been given to them by the evil-minded Duryodhan, the son of Dhritarashtra. And that house was, had been, that house had been set on fire.
在这之前呢，潘德拉兄弟们他们，就是曾经住在用蜡做的房子里面，而这个，这是由 Duryodhan 凶，就是。恶毒的 Duryodhan 做安排的。
So the Pandavas, they managed to escape from the fire, and they had disguised themselves, and they were wandering through different places. And at that time, they came to this village in Ekachakra.
Pandavas 五兄弟呢，他们从这个纵火的这个房子逃出来之后，他们就到各处去就是去巡游，然后他们就来到了 Ekachakra 这个村子。
So when they were in Ekachakra, when they came to Ekachakra, they met with Vyasadev, and Vyasadev told them, "There's a nice pious Brahmana. You can go and stay with him."
当他们来到 Ekachakra 的时候，他们遇到了 Vyasadev。Vyasadev 就对他们说：“在这个村子有一个非常虔诚的婆罗门，你们可以和这个婆罗门住在一起。”
So the Pandavas, Krishna,
still echoing.
So anyway, the Pandavas met.With the Brahmana.
Maharaj, just a moment. We turn off the amplifier.
I think so.
现在好一点吗? Do you feel better?
I don't know. Let's see. We'll try.
Okay.
Okay, so the Brahmana was very poor, but the Brahmana agreed to give them half of his house, give half of the house for the Pandavas to live in.The Pandavas had their mother, Kunti, with them. So five Pandavas and mother Kunti, they were all living in the house of the Brahmana.
那个婆罗门呢是很贫穷的，那么但是他仍然把自己的家的一半的地方，都给了，都让给了 Pandava 们，因为 Pandava 他们不仅仅有五兄弟，然后呢还有 Kunti 女王也是跟他们在一起的，所以他们就都住在这个婆罗门的家。
So every day the Brahmana would have to go out to beg to get some food, otherwise he had nothing to eat.
每天呢 ,Pandava 们他们都会去就是到各个到外面去乞讨祈求食物，否则的话呢他们就没东西吃了。
So when the Pandavas came to stay there, the Pandavas also would go out to beg.Four of the brothers would go. One brother would stay back to take care of queen of the mother, Kunti, and the four brothers would all go out to beg, along with the Brahmana.
通常呢，就是当他们每天出去乞讨的时候呢，四个兄弟会出去乞讨，跟这个婆罗门出去乞讨，一个兄弟留在家里照顾母亲。
So one day it happened. It was a Bhishma Dev.Bhishma was staying back to take care of Queen Kunti, and the other four brothers had gone out begging. Bhima, not Bhishma, Bhima.
Bhima, right? Yeah, yeah. 有一天呢 ，Bhima 他就负责来照顾母亲，留在家里了。
So while they were, Bhima was staying with his mother, they could hear the wife of the Brahmana was crying.And they wondered what was wrong, why she was crying.
当 Bhima, 当他们待在这个婆罗门家里的时候，他们就发现这个婆罗门的妻子在那里哭泣。他们就觉得很奇怪，说，哎，为什么，你在那里哭呢？
So the Brahmani, the wife of the Brahmana, she told Queen Kunti and Bhima, she told Kunti that.There's a demon who lives very near, only 4 or 5 miles away. And the demon is named Bakasura.
所以然后这个婆罗门的妻子就告诉昆提说，在这里附近大概离我们有四五里远的地方呢，住着一个恶魔，这个恶魔的名字是巴卡苏拉。
So that demon used to come to the village every day, and he would come and kill people and animals, and he would eat them.
那么这个恶魔呢，他以前呢，就是经常到我们村子里面来，然后呢，去杀人放火，然后呢，把村里人给吃了，吃人魔。
So all the people in the village, they had a meeting, and they went to the demon.And they spoke to the demon, and they told the demon that they didn't like him to come there every day. They said, every day we will send you one person and a cartload of food, and also you can eat the two buffaloes which pull the cart.
然后呢，就是村里人他们就开了个会，就商量决定说，他们要跟这个恶魔谈一谈，就是他们就跟这个恶魔说呢，这样就是你最好就不要到我们村里来，我们呢每天呢会给你，就是说会给你送人来的，我们会选一个人，然后呢让两个水牛拉车把它。把这个人呢拉到你那边去，这样的话呢，你就可以把这个人和这两头水牛呢一起给吃了，就是你。
So when the demon heard this, he said, "Oh yeah, well this is very good." He said, "If you do like that, then I won't bother you. I won't have to come to your village every day."
然后这个恶魔就说，好啊，这是好事啊。如果你们主动送上门的话，那我就不用到你们村子里面去了。
So in this way, all the people in the village, they would all take turns. One day it would be the turn of one villager, and next day it would be the turn of another family. Each of the different homes, they had to take turns to send a person and animals and food to the demon.
那所以呢，就是说村子里呢，他们每天就安排一个村里人，就给这个恶魔给送过去。所以呢，今天是这个村，是村子里的这个人，明天呢就轮到下面一个人这样的。
And the village was very big. There were many people in the village, so the people in the village they would get turns. It would take many years before they would get it would be their turn.
所以呢，就是因为这个村子还是蛮大的，所以要每。就是说每天供一个人的话呢，就是说每天每家就是每家就是说轮一回的话，也要很长时间才轮到一回要供一个人出去。
So it happened that while the Pandavas were staying there, it was the turn of that Brahmana, that it was his turn. He was meant to give some to send someone and to send a cartload of food.And two animals for the demon to eat.
所以呢，当潘德玛五兄弟住在这个婆罗门家的时候，就正好轮到这个婆罗门家要进贡了。就是这个婆罗门家呢，他们要安排一车的好吃的，然后要供一个人，然后呢要供两头动物，要给这个恶魔给送过去。
So even there was a drummer. He would have to go around, and he would go to the house and say, tomorrow it's your turn. Tomorrow you have to arrange for the food for the demon.
所以呢，就是有专门一个通知的人，所以呢，他就专门通知这个婆罗门说，明天呢就是轮到你们家了哈。所以呢，你们家要准备好这个贡品，然后呢，去要把这些东西送到恶魔那里去。
So this Brahmana had.He had actually four people in his family. There was him and his wife, and he had a 10-year-old son, and then he had an 8-year-old daughter.
那么这个婆罗门家呢，一共有四口人。那么他本人和他的妻子，然后有一个10岁的儿子和8岁的女儿。
So the Brahmana arranged. He arranged a big cartload of food. He filled the cartload with all kinds of nice food. rice and cakes and different things to eat. And he had two buffaloes also. And then he had to decide who will go, which person will go to be eaten by the demon.
所以呢，这个婆罗门呢，他就安排了，就是一辆车，这个平板车上就是有各种各样很好的贡品啊，有米啦，有蛋糕啦，各种各样好吃的。然后他也安排了两头水牛拉这个车。那么最后呢，他就要决定说，到底谁把谁供出去给这个恶魔送过去把被吃掉。
So the Brahmana, he was thinking, you know, I'm the father, it's my duty. He said, I will go, let him eat me.
所以这个婆罗门就想说，我是一家之主，我是这个孩子们的父亲，那让我就跟着这个牛车去吧，我会去的。
But the 10-year-old son said to his father, he said, no, father, you don't go, I will go, let me go.
但是这个十岁的儿子就说了不啊爸爸你不能去的让我去吧。
So when his son said like that, then the Brahmana, he started to cry because he thought my son is so compassionate, he's so kind.
所以当这个儿子这么对他爸爸说的时候呢这个婆罗门的父亲他就开始哭泣了他就觉得说哎呀这个儿子怎么那么就是那么善心那么善呢就是他非常感动。
So the Brahmani, the lady, the wife of the Brahman, she was crying when she heard her son say like that. So that crying that brought Kunti, and Kunti was asking her, what's the problem? And so she told everything to Kunti.
所以呢当这个婆罗门的妻子听到儿子那么乖然后说了这番话之后呢这个妻子也在那里哭泣。所以这个当妻子哭泣的时候呢就引起了就是昆蒂女王的注意然后就去询问了她缘由。
But Kunti said to the lady, she said, don't cry. She said, I have 5 sons. I'll give you one of my sons. You only have 1 son. I'll give you one of my sons.
所以昆蒂呢就对这个婆罗门的妻子说了啊不要哭你只有一个儿子而我呢有5个儿子所以呢我可以就是选一个儿子然后呢去做这个贡品。
So,
你就不用担心。
Kunti knew the strength of Bhima. She knew her son Bhima is very strong, very powerful.So she thought, I'll send Bhima, and Bhima will kill the demon, and then all the villagers will be saved.
所以呢，昆蒂就想说要把 Bhima 送过去，因为他知道 Bhima 是非常强大有力的。然后Bhima 过去的话呢，他可以把这个恶魔搞定了，把这个恶魔给杀了。这样的话，全村人都可以就是没有不再有烦恼了。
So Queen Kunti said to her son Bhima, she said, can you go to that place, go and see that demon Bakasura?
对昆蒂呢就对他的儿子 Bhima 说你能不能去那个恶魔的地方 Bakasura 的地方去跟他会面呢
And Queen Kunti told Bhima, she said, you know, this Brahmana family have been so kind to us. They have given us shelter.In the times of our need, we should help them.
所以昆蒂就对 Bhima 说你看这家婆罗门对我们那么好他们给我们庇护所以呢当他们有难的时候我们也要帮他们。
They have only 1 son, and their son has to go as food for that demon. So they're crying.So, better you go.
所以就是昆蒂就继续就说到了这个婆罗门呢他们只有一个儿子而他们都在那里伤心哭泣所以呢最好还是你去吧 Bhima。
So when Bhima heard that he has to go and he saw there's a big cart of food to take with, he thought, yeah, yeah, I will go, no problem.
所以呢 ,Bhima 呢他看到那个牛车上有很多好吃的，他说好呀好呀，我去我去，没问题。
And so he was riding on the cart and he was eating all the food in the cart as well.
所以呢 ,Bhima 他就坐上了这个牛车，然后一边坐着牛车，他就把牛车上好吃的都一边在那儿吃的。
And he was riding in the cart and he would shout out as he went along, hey demon, hey big demon, Bakasura, where are you? Come on, come out.
然后呢这个 Bhima 他坐在牛车上一边吃着好吃的一边呢就在那儿吼着说，哎，恶魔你在哪儿呢，出来让我看看，来吧来吧，你在哪儿呢？
So the demon could hear all the noise, he could hear Bhima shouting.So he came out and he saw Bhima eating his food. He became very angry.
So this 恶魔呢，他就能够很远处就听到了 Bhima 在那儿吼啊，然后他出来看，又看到 Bhima 在吃他给他的贡品，所以呢，这个恶魔他非常的生气。
So the demon was so angry, he ripped out a tree from the ground, a big tree. He ripped it out from the ground and he threw it on Bhima.
所以呢，这个恶魔他那么的生气啊，他就从地上拔了一棵树，把它拔起来之后，就向 Bhima 扔过去。
But Bhima didn't worry about it. Bhima did the same thing. He ripped out a big tree and he threw a big tree back at the demon.
而对 Bhima 来说，他根本不害怕，他也从地上拔起一棵大树，然后向这个恶魔扔过去。
So then the two of them got to fight together.And there was a great battle, and Bhima killed that demon.
So, Bhima 和这个恶魔呢，他们就开始了一场战争。最终呢，就 Bhima 他就把这个恶魔给杀了。
And after he killed the demon, he finished eating everything in the cart, and then he came home with the empty cart.
So, 当Bhima 把这个恶魔杀了之后呢，他又把车上所有好吃的给吃光了，然后最后呢，他就和这又让牛车把他拉回去了。
But what happened was, while Bhima was out going to Bakasura to kill Bakasura, at that time Arjuna came home, and he saw that Bhima wasn't there.
但是当 Bhima 他去就是杀 Bakasura 的时候 ，Arjuna。当时呢就回到了家里，他就发现就是 Bhima 不在家。
So he asked Mother Kunti, he said, where's my brother? Where's Bhima? And Queen Kunti told Arjuna what had happened.
所以呢 ,Arjuna 就问 Kunti 女王说，我的兄弟 Bhima 在哪儿呢？所以呢Kunti 女王就把这个事情的来龙去脉告诉了 Arjuna。
Yeah, he told Arjuna that Bhima's gone to kill the demon Bakasura.
So he said, Bhima, he went to kill Bakasura.
So Arjuna thought, oh, my brother has gone there alone. He must be fighting with that demon. He must be, maybe he's in some trouble.
然后 Arjuna 就想说，哦，我的弟弟去跟恶魔作战了，肯定有些麻烦。
So Arjuna told his mother, told Queen Kunti, said, I'm going to go to help Bhima. You stay here in the Brahmin's house. I have to go to help Bhima.
所以 Arjuna 就对他的妈妈说了，你待在家里哈，我得去帮帮我的弟弟 Bhima。大家记得静音哦，我看听到一些背景的杂音，会影响到大家的聆听和Guru的讲课，请大家呢确保你是在静音的状态，谢谢。
So Arjuna took his Gandiva bow. When he was going out of the house, he took his Gandiva bow and arrows.And then, when he was on the way, he was thinking about what to do.
当 Arjuna 出门的时候，他就拿起了他的 Gandiva 的弓然后呢他就想着说怎么办。
So he thought it's going to take me some time to get there where Bhima is, to get to the place of the demon. And Bhima may already be in some big trouble.
所以 Arjuna 一边走的时候一边在那担心说，哎，我从这里走到那个 Bhima这个恶魔和Bhima打仗，就是说打斗的地方的话，还有一段时间，可能呢Bhima他会有一些麻烦。
So Arjuna decided, he said, I will fire one of my Nagapasha astras. He had a snake arrow, an arrow which is actually a snake which he could fire. So Arjuna got ready one of these snake arrows to fire.
所以呢 ，Arjuna 就想说，让我现在就，就是说发一个武器啊。他有这个武器呢，就是说有一个，就是他的这个弓，这个Gandiva弓啊，它可以发射蛇的箭，就是。所以呢，他就准备要把这个蛇的这个箭呢，发射出去去救Bhima。
So when he was getting ready to fire the snake arrow, he said to the snake, he said, you go and bind up that demon.
对他发这一箭的时候，他就对这个蛇说，你去到那里把这个恶魔，你去攻击这个恶魔。
You know, the snake actually is a cobra, it's a very big poisonous snake.
这个蛇呢，其实是大蟒蛇来的，毒性非常的大。
So Arjuna was he fired the arrow and he kept going. He wants to find Bhima, and so when he was on the road, he met Bhima coming, and he saw Bhima had already defeated the demon.
所以呢 ，Arjuna 呢，他就把这个蛇的这支箭呢给发出去了。发完之后呢，然后在他去的路上，他就遇到了 Bhima 啊，他才意识到 Bhima 已经把这个恶魔搞定了。
And、so when Arjuna heard the demon was already dead, then Arjuna regretted. He said, "Oh, I've already sent a big cobra, a big snake arrow."
所以当 Arjuna 遇到 Bhima 的时候，他又开始担心了。哎呀，我已经把那个蛇的那个箭给发出去了。
So he said that snake must be moving around different places, eating different people. So I'd better do something、
哎、
about it.
所以呢 ，Arjuna 就想说，这个我发出这个蛇箭的话呢，是很厉害的。如果就是已经恶魔已经被干掉的话，那但是问题是这个蛇的话，它还是会到处走，然后可能会攻击其他人。我得做点什么。
So Arjuna, he went to where the snake was moving about, and Arjuna said to the snake, he said, "All right, you cobra, you have to stay underneath this tamala tree here."
所以呢 ，Arjuna 他就找到了这条蛇，然后就对这条蛇说。你这个蟒蛇，你呢得乖乖的待在这棵 tamala 树下。
And Arjuna told the snake, he said, "Don't move anywhere else. Don't go and harm any other people."
Arjuna 就对这条蛇说呢，你不要去任何其他的地方，不要去伤害任何其他的人。
But the cobra said to Arjuna, he said, "Well, if I do that, how can I survive? What will I eat?"
If I do that?
He said, "How will I survive? How can I maintain
okay,
my life? What
okay,
will I eat?"
Okay. 这个蟒蛇就对 Arjuna 说了，你让我就待在树下，哪儿都不能去，谁都不能吃，那我怎么活呢？我吃啥呢？
So Arjuna said, "Well, whoever comes to this tamal tree, you can eat him. You can eat that living entity, but don't go away. Don't go away from the tree."
Arjuna 就对这个蟒蛇说了，那这样吧，谁 来到这棵特妈树下你就能吃它，但是呢不要到外面去伤害别人。
Don't eat people any other place.
也就是说不要到其他的地方去吃其他的生物。
So in this way this cobra was telling Lord Nityananda, he said, so from that time on I've been here.From the previous yuga, from the time when the Pandavas came here, I've been here all that time.
所以呢，这个蟒蛇就把他的故事告诉了主尼铁南达。他说，自从那时候开始，直到现在的话，我就一直待在这儿。
And he said, the cobra said, whoever comes here, then I eat them.
所以呢，这个蟒蛇就说了。谁来到这棵特玛尔树下的话，我就把它给吃了。
So then Lord Nityananda heard all this story from the cobra. So the Lord Nityananda says to the cobra, he says, all right, then you stay here, but you stay inside this hole. Don't come out of this hole.
那么就Nityananda就对这个蟒蛇说了，好了，好吧，那你就待这儿吧。但是那个你得待在这个洞里面，不要出来。
And don't eat anyone. Don't come out and don't eat anyone.
所以呢，你不要从洞里出来，也不要吃任何人。
Don't go and eat all the innocent people.
不要去伤害无辜。
But the cobra said, then how can I survive? What will I eat?
但这个蟒蛇就说，那我怎么活呢？我吃什么呢？
But Lord Nityananda said, no, people will come and worship you and offer food to you.
那主尼铁南达就说了，不用担心，人们会来到你面前，然后呢，会来崇拜你，会向你会给你贡品。
Yeah, they'll give you food. They'll offer boga to you. They'll offer food to you.And you can eat it.
那么，所以呢，人们他们就会来到你面前，然后呢，他们会向你供给你食物。那么这个时候你就能吃。
But don't eat people and don't eat any animals or any other creature.
但是呢，不要去吃任何的动物或者任何的生物体。
Just stay inside this hole and don't come out of the hole.
你就待在这个洞里面，别出来。
So at that time, Lord Nityananda took one of his golden earrings out of his ear, and he put it on the mouth of the hole.
所以呢，这个时候主尼铁南达就从他的耳朵上把他的耳环，一个金的耳环拿下来，然后呢，就放到了这条蛇待的那个洞的这个洞口，把它堵住。
So from that day.Lord Nityananda or Lord Balaram has only one earring.
所以呢，从那一天开始，主尼铁南达或者说主巴拉拉玛，他只有一个耳环。
So that earring that's like a kundala. So that earring was placed there on the hole.And it became like a big block of stone. And it blocked the whole hole.
那么这个耳环呢，它就是像kundala. Kundala is a kind of flower, am I right?
Kundala is referring to the earring.
Okay. 所以呢，就是这个耳环是kundala。那么它呢是很大的，所以就把整个的洞蛇呆的那个洞口给堵住了。
And so at that place now there's a very nice temple built over there.
所以在那个所以在那个地方呢就有一个非常非常棒的一个庙宇。
Yeah, that place is called Kundalitala, or the place that it's called Kundali Damana, and many people go there to worship.
那么这个地方呢，现在就叫做Kundali Damana, 啊，很多人都会在去那里来做崇拜。
And they bring boga and offer the food to the snake, and this way the cobra gets food.
所以呢，他们都会带来供奉的食物然后就这样呢，这个蛇它就得到了它的食物，
so、
有东西吃了。
So this is one of the famous pastimes of Lord Nityananda there in Ekachakra.
所以这就是主尼天南达在 Ekachakra 发生的一个非常著名的逍遥时光。
So Lord Nityananda lived there in Ekachakra as a young boy, but after some time, he saw his parents were very attached to him.
Ekachakra, 他在 Ekachakra 呢，就是作为一个小男孩就住在那里，然后他的父母亲呢非常的依恋他。
So Lord Nityananda arranged that one mendicant would come there to Ekachakra and stay in their home.
于是呢，主尼天南达他就安排了有一个弃绝者，然后去能够去拜访他们家。住在他们家里。
So Lord Nityananda's father, he told the Brahmana, he told the mendicant, he said, if there's anything I can do for you, any service you want, just ask me.
所以呢，就 Nityananda 的父亲就问这个僧人了，就说我能够为您做些什么吗？如果有任何我能做的，请尽管告诉我们。
So then the Brahmana said to Lord Nityananda's father, he said, you know, he said, I'm traveling alone. I'm going to all the holy places. He said, I need an assistant. He said, can you give your son to me?
对，这个僧人他就说了，我现在呢就是到各个地方去旅行，而且呢我是一个人旅行，你能不能把你的儿子给我，跟我结伴旅行呢？
So in this way,Lord Nityananda was given to the sannyasi and he got free from his home, from his mother and father, and he could go to visit all the holy places.
所以就这样呢，主尼天南达他就被给了这个僧，这个弃绝者，这个sannyasi，然后这样的话呢，主尼天南达和这个僧人就一起去拜访了所有的圣地。
Lord Nityananda is not different from Lord Balaram. Lord Balaram also did not take part in the battle of Kurukshetra, but at that time he went to visit all the holy places. So Lord Nityananda wanted to visit them again, to go and see all the holy places. Because he'd visited them before, he wanted to go again. Mm-hmm.
那我们知道主尼天南达就是主巴拉拉玛，而主巴拉拉玛呢，就是也是曾经拜访了所有的这些圣地的，所以作为主尼天南达，他想要再次回到这些圣地去。
So Lord Nityananda, for many years he was traveling with the sannyasi, going around. At one point, after many years, they came to Vrindavan.And then Lord Nityananda heard how Lord Chaitanya had started the Sankirtan movement.
所以呢，主尼天南达就和这个 Sannyasi 呢一起，去了很多圣地旅行。直到有一天呢，他来到了 Vrindavan， 他就听说，主 Chaitanya 开始了他的 Sankirtan 运动，起诵圣名运动。
So Lord Nityananda made arrangements.To go to Mayapur to join with Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
So Sri Nityananda, he came to Navadvip to join the Sri Chaitanya movement.
And Lord Chaitanya, he'd been telling the devotees that very soon a wonderful personality is going to come here in Mayapur. He's a very great saintly person.And he's going to come here very soon.
然后主持他呀，马哈普布，他就对他的同友们说，很快会有一个非常非常伟大的人物来到这里，很快他就会来了。
So after a couple of days, Lord Chaitanya said, now this person has come, he's already here in Mayapur, you should go and bring him. And so Lord Chaitanya sent Srivas Pandit along with Haridas, go and find this great person and bring him to us.
然后几天之后呢，主持人天阳马尔布啊，他就说，哎，这个伟大的人物已经来了。于是他就派了 Srivas Pandit 和Srivas Pandit 和 Haridas 去把让他们把这个伟大的人物给带过来，找出来。
So the two of them went and they searched all over Mayapur. They went everywhere, but they could not find this person who Chaitanya Mahaprabhu had been talking about. They went to so many houses, so many homes, but they couldn't find this person.
那么 Srivas Pandit 和 Haridas Thakur 他们找遍了所有的地方啊，所有的住家都找不到。
Then they came back after many hours and they told Lord Chaitanya, we can't find him anywhere. So Lord Chaitanya said,Then I will lead you to him. And this shows that it's very mysterious to find out Lord Nityananda. It's not an easy thing. You have to have special power.
所以呢，找了 Srivas Pandit 和 Haridas Thakur， 他们找了好多个小时都找不到，他们只能跟主持天阿妈婆汇报说，我们已经找遍了。然后主持天阿妈就对他们说：“好吧，我来带你们去我来带你们去找到这个人。”所以在这一点上的话，其实是有很重要的一个训语，就是说，要找到地天丹的 Prabhu 的话，不是一件容易的事情，所以是需要非常特别的仁慈或者揭示的。
So Lord Chaitanya led the devotees, and they went with.Performing Sankirtan, and he led them to the home of Nandan Acharya. And there in the home of Nandan Acharya, they saw this tall, very powerfully built, saintly person chanting the holy names.
所以呢，主持他呀，马哈帕布就和他的同友们一路唱着齐颂圣名，然后就去到了南德查尔的家。在南德查尔的家呢，他们就看到了这位高大圣洁的尼提南达。
Yeah, this Nandanacharya's home is it just next door to the gate of our ISKCON temple. When you come along the road from the Yoga Peak, and then the next house, the next gate after.Mayapur, then that's the home of Nandanacharya.
所以就是Nandanacharya的家呢，其实就在我们的玛雅普庙宇的隔壁。我们如果从 Yoga Pit, 就这天马普显现的地方叫 Yoga Pit, 然后过来就是我们的庙，再过一个门就是Nandanacharya的家。
So they could see this personality with.He was chanting the holy name with great ecstasy. So all the devotees were shocked to see him. And Lord Chaitanya wanted to impress upon them all that how saintly and how pure this Lord Nityananda was.
所以当大家看到主尼天南达的时候他主尼天南达都是在那里吟诵圣名，处在狂喜极乐当中。所以主持人天马哈巴布呢也是想借这个机会让大家能够看到或者意识到主尼天南达有多么圣洁和伟大。
So Lord Chaitanya turned to one of the devotees and he asked him, he said,Please recite a verse describing the beauty of Lord Krishna in Vrindavan.
于是呢，主持他呀就转头转身呢就跟他的一个同友说，请你吟诵一个关于 Vrindavan 的诗节，关于 Vrindavan 的主这个诗节。
So one of the devotees recited a beautiful verse describing how Lord Krishna is decorated with.Flowers in his ears, and how he's playing on his flute, and how he's decorating the ground with his beautiful lotus footprints.
所以呢，这个奉献者他就吟诵了一个诗节，就讲述了 Krishna 啊，美丽的 Krishna 他怎么样去吹他的笛子，然后呢，他是是怎么样用他的莲花足来装点大地，以及他的这个这个形象外貌。
And when the devotees sang this verse, then immediately Lord Nityananda's ecstatic love for Krishna was awakened, and he began to cry and roll on the ground and shed tears.
所以当这个奉献者一旦在吟诵这个诗节的时候，主尼天南的听到这个诗节之后，陷入了狂喜极乐，他的泪如泉涌，然后在地上翻打滚。
And Lord Nityananda shed so many tears, the whole floor became flooded with his tears.
主尼天南的呢，他流了那么多的眼泪，整个地上全部都被他的眼泪给淹没了。
All the devotees were shocked to see such ecstatic love awakened in the body of Lord Nityananda.
所有的奉献者都是那么的震惊，就是看到主尼天南达的这些狂喜极乐的这些征兆的话，都感到非常的震惊。
They could understand what a great devotee he must be.
他们能够理解到他是一个多么伟大的奉献者。
So Lord Nityananda came to stay in Mayapur, and generally he would stay in the home of Srivas Pandit.
So, Nityananda, he in Navadvip residence, usually he stayed in Srivas Pandit's house.
And every day, of course, every night there would be the evening, the nocturnal kirtans of Lord Chaitanya every night.
而每天晚上呢，他们都会和主切丹呀有一起来做 kirtan。
So Lord Nityananda was living there when came time for Lord Chaitanya to take sannyas, and Lord Nityananda also went to Katwa to see the sannyas ceremony of Lord Chaitanya.
所以呢，主尼天南达就一直住在Shiva's Pandit 的家，直到呢有一天主切坦亚马哈帕布准备要去接受三尼亚斯的启迪，那么尼天南达也一起去了卡特瓦，参加了这个三尼亚斯的启迪仪式。
And it was after the sannyas ceremony, Lord Chaitanya wanted to go to Vrindavan, and Lord Nityananda arranged that instead of going to Vrindavan, that he would go to Shantipur.
那么主持太阳马普布他接受了三加斯启迪之后呢，他就想去 Vrindavan， 但是呢，你天南达他就做了安排，就是说让他最终去香提普了。
And in Shantipur, they stayed at the home of Advaita Acharya.And they sent for Mother Sanchi to come from Mayapur and to spend some time with her son.
在香提普呢，他们住在 Advaita Acharya 的家，然后他们安排了，Chaitanya 的母亲Sanchi 来到香提普，能够见到他的儿子。
So, Lord Nityananda. Lord Chaitanya was not very happy with Lord Nityananda. He said, "You've tricked me. I wanted to go to Vrindavan, but instead you brought me here to Shantipur."
那么主切坦亚呢，对主尼天南达不是很满意，因为他对主尼天南达说，你看我原来要到 Vrindavan 去的，然后你却把我带到了 Shantipur。
But Lord Nityananda thought,told Lord Chaitanya, said, yes, I wanted all the devotees from Mayapur should have the opportunity to see you now that you're a sannyasi, because now you're a sannyasi, you'll be leaving, you're not going to be staying at home, so they have to have your association for one last time before you go.
就你天南达就对主觉太阳说，你现在接受了萨尼亚西启迪，托果森的启迪，我是考虑到所有玛雅布的奉献者，因为你进入气觉阶层之后呢，就会要到各处巡游或者周游，所以他们就没有什么机会再见到你了。所以呢，这就是为什么我就在这里安排你到这里的话呢，他们就再一次有机会来见到你。
So Lord Nityananda arranged Mother Sachi to come, and Mother Sachi would cook for Lord Chaitanya and all the devotees. And this way, the devotees would all be together during the daytime. They would have kirtan, and there would be kathas, and they'd spent several days there with Lord Chaitanya.
So, Nityananda, he made such an arrangement. Then Sachi Mama, she would give everyone a big breakfast, and the volunteers would be able to 整个这段时间就和主觉天下在一起，他们可以讲述Krishna 的体旨，然后一起来唱诵。
And when you go to Shantipur, you can see the places there where Lord Chaitanya would sit and take prasadam in the company of Lord Nityananda and Advaita Acharya.
如果你们去到Shantipur的话，你们可以去看到就是主 Chaitanya 和他的就是说主催他要坐的地方，他当在那个时候和他的奉献者同游，以及主尼田南的和对他的圈呀在那里就是坐在那里或者在那里荣耀的地方。
When they first came there to Shantipur, Advaita Acharya had arranged that there would be a big feast, a very nice opulent prasadam for everyone.But Lord Chaitanya was saying, you know, I'm a sannyasi, I will only eat some rice and some green leaves. He said, I don't want to eat a big meal. Just give me some rice and green leaves.
那么那个时候呢，就是 Advaita Acharya 他在香提普，他很想就是安排一个大餐来招待主切坦亚马哈帕布，但是主切坦亚马哈帕布就对他说，我现在是一个气绝者，我是一个托钵僧了，我不吃大餐，我呢就是只需要一点米饭，然后一点绿叶菜就行了。
嗯 Advaita Acharya said, yes, it's all right, just take what you like, you know. But actually he'd arranged a very big, very big opulent prasadam for everyone.
然后 Advaita Acharya 说没问题啊，我就按您说的办呗。然后呢？但其实他安排了一个非常非常盛大的大餐来招待所有人。
Lord Chaitanya was thinking this is too much prasadam, but Lord Nityananda, he complained. He said, "Look, I've been fasting for 3 days to come here to Shantipur, all the way from Kadwa. We came all the way from Kadwa to Shantipur. It'd take us 3 days."I'd been fasting for 3 days. I thought I was going to end my fast.
那么主持他呢，他就觉得说，哎呀，这个大餐太丰盛了。但同时呢，那主那天南达又在那儿抱怨说，哎呀，搞什么搞啊？我从卡特瓦过来三天，走了三天回来，这个我本来是想要吃一顿大餐来打破戒食的，结果这个菩萨的安排那么惨。
He said, Advaita Acharya called me to eat, but it's the quantity of food will not even fill half of my belly.
Advaita Acharya 呢，请我来吃饭，结果呢，这个安排的这个菩萨呢，根本喂就是不能喂饱我半个胃。
And Advaita Acharya said to Lord Nityananda, he said, well, look, you're supposed to be a traveling mendicant on pilgrimage.
那么主持他就对Nityananda说，你看，你应该是一个就是旅行的僧侣来的。
So when you're like that, sometimes you may eat some fruits and roots, and sometimes you simply fast.
所以呢，有时候呢，你就应就就是得吃一些什么根树根啦，或者水果啦，或者有没东西吃，那你就戒食呗。
And Advaita Acharya says, "I'm just a poor Brahmana. You've come to my home. Please be satisfied with whatever food I've given you."
那对他恰尔就对主尼天丹丹说。哎呀，主尼天丹的，我只是一个贫穷的婆罗门啊，所以呢，你来吃饭呢，请你就知足吧。我这个有什么能吃的，请你知足吧。
Stop being so greedy.
啊，请不要那么贪婪。
And when Lord Nityananda heard this, he said, "Well, whatever I may be, whatever you say, but you have invited me." You brought me here, so you should supply as much food as I want to eat.
可能你要说我是这个是那个，但是呢，你是是你邀请我来到你家里吃饭的，所以你必须得管饱呀。
So when Advaita Acharya heard him speak like that, then Advaita Acharya said to him, he said.You are just a reject Paramahamsa. You've taken the renounced order of life just to fill your belly.
然后就觉得呀，就是说，然后他就对尼天丹丹说了啊，你是一个啊，应该被摒弃的 Paramahamsa 啊，你到处周游就是为了填饱肚子。
Your business is just to give trouble to innocent brahmanas like me.
你的所有的这个目的呢，就是要对像我这种的婆罗门制造麻烦。
So when Advaita Acharya called Lord Nityananda a reject Paramahamsa, actually it's a glorification. It's not an insult.
所以当Advaita Acharya 把就是说那天丹的称为是要接受要 Paramahamsa 就是被摒弃的 Paramahamsa 他其实是对主那天丹的荣耀。
There's always a big difference of opinion between the Brahmanas, those people who are Brahmanas by birth, and those who are Vaishnavas.
因为就是一个就是一个就是出生在外士那瓦家出生在婆罗门家庭的婆罗门出生的人和这个外士那瓦他们之间的这个定义始终是有争议的。
So when Advaita Acharya said to Lord Nityananda that you're a reject Paramahamsa, it was a glorification of Lord Nityananda.
对，当Advaita Acharya把Nityananda称为被摒弃的Paramahamsa，被摒弃的至尊天鹅的时候，其实也是一种荣耀。
It's actually Advaita Acharya is accepting Lord Nityananda as a real Paramahamsa.
这意味着说Advaita Acharya把就那天丹的接受为一位真正的至尊天鹅。
Lord Nityananda we cannot identify Lord Nityananda as having anything to do with the caste Brahmanas, those people who are Brahmanas by birth. Lord Nityananda has nothing to do with those people.
那么就那天丹的呢？他和这些种姓制度里的婆罗门是完全不一样的。
So Advaita Acharya was actually praising Lord Nityananda.
所以 Advaita Acharya 他其实是在是在赞美主那天丹的。
So some people claim to be Paramahamsas, but they're Paramahamsas just for the sense gratification.
有些人呢，他们被称为是 Paramahamsa 至尊天鹅，但是呢，他们只是在那里是为了达到他们感官享乐的目的。
But Lord Nityananda, he's not interested in sense gratification.
但是呢，主尼天南达对感官享乐没有任何的兴趣。
嗯 ，Lord Nityananda is he is the real Paramahamsa。
主尼天南达他是一个真正的至尊天鹅。
But sometimes he may take the dress of a sannyasi, and sometimes not.
有时候呢，他会穿上 sannyasi 的这个服装，有时候不穿。
Sometimes he will dress like a householder.
有时候呢，他会穿得像一个居士。
So when Lord Nityananda was being addressed by Advaita Acharya in that way.It was, these were just joking words between the two.
对呢，当阿德维塔Acharya是这样去称呼就是天南达的时候呢，他们只是在就开玩笑而已。
Advaita Acharya said to Lord Nityananda, he said, "I know you can eat many kilos of rice, and I'm just a poor brahmana."How can I feed you so much rice?
那么对他查亚他也对你天南的说啊，我知道你其实是可以吃好几公斤的米饭啊，但是呢，我只是一个贫穷的婆罗门，我怎么能够供得起那么多米饭呢
？So Advaita Acharya said to him, he said, "Maybe you just have a panful of rice, but just eat it, please eat it, and then get up."Don't show your madness.
然后对他起来就对他说你可能只有那个一手掌的米饭，你就把它给吃了，然后知足吧别在那儿别在这儿展示你的疯狂。
And don't throw food about the place. Don't throw food all everywhere.
不要把东西到处乱扔，不要把食物到处乱扔。
So then they sat down, all the three of them, Advaita Acharya, Nityananda, and Lord Chaitanya, they sat together and they took their food and they would eat. And as Lord Chaitanya would eat, they put more food on his plate.
所以呢，就是就 Nityananda, 就 Chaitanya 和 Advaita Acharya, 他们就在那儿荣耀。然后当主 Chaitanya, 他吃了一点沙等的时候呢，他们马上又给他加很多。
And so the more Lord Chaitanya ate, the more they would put on his plate.
那么就 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 他吃的越多，他们就给他加的越多。
And they were eating and eating. Then Lord Nityananda began joking again. He said, "My belly isn't filled yet. I'm not getting a full belly."
然后就那天丹丹又开始开玩笑了，他就说哎呀我根本吃都吃不饱啊，一点都没饱呢。
Better you take this food away. I'm not taking much of it.
最好你们把这些饭菜都撤了吧，根本是填不饱肚子，撤了撤了。
And then Lord Nityananda took some rice in his hand.And he threw it on the floor in front of him as if he was angry.
然后呢，就那天丹丹呢，就把这个抓起了一把米饭，就扔在地上去展示他的愤怒。
But when he threw the rice, some of the rice touched the body of Advaita Acharya, and when it touched his body, Advaita Acharya began to dance.
在当就那天丹丹他把这个米饭扔到地上的时候呢，有一些米饭呢就溅到了阿德塔查尔的身上，然后阿德塔查尔就因为这样的触碰开始狂喜起舞。
All the rice, the pieces of rice were still stuck to his body, but he was dancing.
这些米饭都粘在他身上，但他在那儿狂喜舞蹈。
Advaita Acharya thought himself to be, he understood the touch of the rice was the remnants of Lord Nityananda, and Lord Nityananda is a Paramahamsa. So he's been purified by the touch of the remnants.
那么Advaita Acharya 他理解到呢 is that Echo Maharaj?
No.
some sound.
Yeah, birds. There's some birds outside.
Oh, birds from your side. That's okay. Okay. 所以呢，就对他 Taraya 他就理解到说，这些米沾在他身上的米饭是主尼天南达的鲫鱼所以呢，这是主尼天南达赐给他的特殊的仁慈，所以他的那么。而且呢，朱尼天南达他是吃尊天鹅，所以呢，这是朱尼天南达给到他的特别的仁慈，所以呢 ，Advaita Acharya 就在那儿狂喜起舞。
That's why Advaita Acharya was dancing。
那么这就是为什么 Advaita Acharya 在那里舞蹈。
He wants to show us the power of the remnants of the great devotees。
他想向我们展示就是伟大奉献者的觊觎的力量强大的力量伟大的力量
Ordinary people, they don't know about the power of Mahaprasadam
普通的人他们不知道 Mahaprasadam 的力量
So then Advaita Acharya said to Lord Nityananda, he said, oh my dear Nityananda, I brought you here to my home. I invited you, and now I have received the results of doing that. Because I brought you to my home, look what has happened.
然后Advaita Acharya对Nityananda说，你看我把你请到家里来吃饭，现在看看发生了什么呀？
You have no caste.And we don't know where you're from, and by nature you're just a madman.
他说你根本就是没有阶层，没有种姓，然后呢，没有什么身份，只是一个疯子而已。
And you're a madman, and you throw your food at me to make me a madman like you.
你是一个疯子，然后呢，你又把你吃剩的东西都丢在我身上，然后呢，让我也成为跟你一样的疯子。
And you're not even afraid that I'm a brahmana, and you're doing this.
而且你甚至不就是说你就是我是婆罗门啊，你对我这样对待我的话，你甚至没有任何的担心或者害怕。
So Lord Nityananda said.This is the remnants of food from Lord Krishna. This is Lord Krishna's remnants. If you take them to be ordinary food, that is an offense.
主尼天南达就对他说了，这是 Krishna 的觊觎，所以如果你就是说你觉得这个你就是不去。如果你不去好好就是好好的珍惜这些鲫鱼的话，那么这就是一种冒犯了。
Yeah, we should never consider prasadam to be ordinary.
对，我们永远不要认为 prasadam 是普通的。
It may just be rice and dal. It may be very simple, but if it's prasadam, it's spiritual.
可能是很简单的，只是米饭和豆汤。但是只要是 prasadam， 那么就是。灵性的。
So Lord Nityananda then says to Advaita, he said, now you have to invite 100 sannyasis to your home and feed them sumptuously. And only in that way you'll get relief from your offense.
然后就Nityananda说，现在呢，你如果要从这个冒犯当中摆脱出来的话，那你就得请100个 sannyasi 一起到你家里吃饭。
So Advaita Acharya said, I'm never going to invite another sannyasi to my home.
Advaita Acharya 说，我永远不再会再请其他任何一个 sannyasi 到我家里来吃饭了。
Just look, I brought this sannyasi to my home today, and look what has happened. You've ruined all of my spiritual, all of my brahminical regulations.
就看一看吧，我今天请了一个婆罗门到我家就把我所有的婆罗门的这些规范规仪全部给打破了。
So this was the joking relationship between Lord Nityananda and Advaita Acharya.
所以呢，这就是朱尼天南达和阿杜塔查亚之间的这个开玩笑的这个逍遥时光。
It's giving a lot of them. All the devotees were enjoying hearing the joking words between the two people.
所有的奉献者呢，他们听到他们俩之间的这样的一个这些玩笑话呢，都很高兴。
So in the Panchatattva, there are three Vishnu Tattvas. There is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu, and Advaita Acharya. All of these three are Vishnu Tattvas.
那么在五圣体当中呢，有三位是 Vishnu Tattva， 也就是是主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Nityananda Prabhu 和 Advaita Acharya.
But the Advaita and Nityananda, they both come as the servants of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
但是呢，就 Advaita Acharya 和 Nityananda 的话呢，他们都是作为主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 或者主的仆人的身份出现。
So we have to understand it's very important if we want to approach Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we have to approach him through Lord Nityananda.
所以我们要很清楚，如果我们想要去接近主 Chaitanya 的话，我们要首先通过主 Nityananda。
Lord Nityananda is the original. He's not different from Lord Balaram, and Lord Balaram is the original spiritual master.
主 Nityananda 是就是主 Balarama， 而主 Balarama 是原初的灵性导师。
And so Lord Nityananda would always be in the mood of the servant of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And people would come to Lord Nityananda to get his blessings, to go to Radha and Krishna, and to go to take shelter of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
所以呢，就是主 Nityananda 他总是在那里服务主 Chaitanya。人们他们想要去如果想要去接近主 Chaitanya 或者是接近 Radha Krishna 的话，他们会首先去寻求主 Nityananda 的庇护。
Lord Nityananda had many disciples, and one of his disciples was Vrindavan Das Thakur, who wrote the Chaitanya Bhagavat.
主 Nityananda 有很多的门徒。其中的一个门徒呢是 Vrindavan Das Thakur， 他写了 Chaitanya Bhagavat 这本书。
So Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur is considered the incarnation of Srila Vyasadeva in Chaitanya Lila.
Vrindavan Das Thakur 他被认为是主 Chaitanya 逍遥时光的 Vyasadeva。
And Sri Chaitanya, Srila Vrindavan Das Thakur describes himself.As the last disciple of Lord Nityananda.
Vrindavan Das Thakur 呢，他就把自己描述为是主 Nityananda 的最后一位门徒。
So Lord Nityananda also plays an important part in the life of Krishna Das Kaviraj, who wrote the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
主 Nityananda 呢，他也是对Krishna Das Kaviraj。来说的话，也是在他的生命当中有重要的地位。而 Krishna Das Kaviraj 呢，他是撰写《永恒 Chaitanya 经》的作者。
Krishna Das Kaviraj had been staying with his family, and his brother was not a devotee of Lord Nityananda. His brother had faith in Lord Chaitanya, but no faith in Lord Nityananda.
Krishna Das Kaviraj 呢，他和他的兄弟住在一起，但是呢，他的兄弟，他们家呢是对主 Chaitanya 有信心，但是呢，却对主 Nityananda 没有信心。
So his brother Krishna Das Kaviraj, he would tell his brother that to have faith in Lord Chaitanya and no faith in Lord Nityananda is like the logic of a half a hen.
所以呢，who told who? Sorry, Maharaj.
Krishna Das Kaviraj told his brother.
Okay, 所以 Krishna Das Kaviraj 他就对他的兄弟说， 那么当一个人他对主 Chaitanya 有信心而对主 Nityananda 没有信心的话，那么这就好像是半只鸡的逻辑。
If you have the, you want to keep the back part of the chicken because it lays eggs, you don't want the front part because it eats the food, how is it possible? You cannot separate the front from the back.
Yeah. 这个逻辑是什么呢？就是说一只鸡对吧，你只想要它的后半部分，它后面下蛋的后半部分你想要，然后前面吃食的这个吃东西的这个嘴的这个部分你不想要，你只想要它下蛋的这一部分，这怎么可能呢？所以这就是半只鸡的逻辑。
And the same way, if you want to have Lord Chaitanya, you don't want to have Lord Nityananda, that is very foolish.
同样的，如果你只是想要主 Chaitanya, 而不想要主 Nityananda 的话，那么这也是非常愚蠢的。
So it happened that in the home of Krishnadas Kaviraj and his brother, there was everyday kirtan, and they had also one brahmana there who was doing the puja for the deities. And it happened that one day they were visited by a great devotee of Lord Nityananda.
那么在Krishnadas Kaviraj 和他的这个兄弟家呢，就是说他们每天在那里会有唱诵的，然后。他们会在那里的专门有一个婆罗门来做神像的崇拜。那么有一天呢，主 Nityananda 的一个奉献者去拜访了他们。
Yeah, the devotee of Lord Nityananda, he was very famous. His name was Miniketana Ramdas.
那么这个主 Nityananda 的奉献者呢，是非常著名的奉献者，叫 Miniketana Das.
Miniketana Ramdas.
Miniketana Ramdas.
Yeah, Ramdas. We will call him Ramdas. So, okay, so he came to the house of Krishnadas Kaviraj, but when he came there, this brother of Krishnadas Kaviraj was not nice to him. He did not welcome him in the home.
所以呢，就当这个奉献者去拜访这个 Krishnadas Kaviraj 的这个兄弟这一家的时候呢，他的这个兄弟对他态度不太好。
Miniketana Ramdas was a very joyful person. He would slap people's faces, and when they would offer obeisances to him, he would climb on their back. In this way, he would joke with people.
那 Miniketana Ramdas 呢？他是一个很风趣的人啊，就是啊，比如说别人跟他顶拜。他就会爬到别人的背上去，然后跟对方开玩笑。
So it happened that while he was there, the brother of Krishnadas Kaviraj was not hospitable, and Miniketana Ramdas said, "He is the second Roma Harshan."
嗯，然后然后呢，就是说 Miniketana Das 呢，他就去到这个 Krishnadas Kaviraj 的兄弟的这个家嘛，然后他的这个兄弟呢，对他态度不是很好，然后呢，Who said Krishnadas Kaviraj consider him the Roma Harshan Sutta?
Roma Harsh Miniketana Ramdas said
okay,
to the brother of Krishnadas Kaviraj.
所以呢，就是Miniketana Ramdas 呢，他就对这个他的这个兄弟就说了，这就好像是另外一个Roma Harshan Sutta一样。
And so he broke his flute and he left in an angry mood.
所以呢，这个Ramdas 他就把他的这个笛子给摔碎了，然后就生气的离开了。
So Krishnadas Kaviraj told his brother, "This is very inauspicious. This is not good for you. Your life will never be auspicious. You have offended a great devotee."
所以 Krishnadas Kaviraj 呢就对他的兄弟说了，这个你看你冒犯了一个伟大的奉献者，就是非常不吉祥的。你接下来的话肯定会有反应，会有问题。
So that night, When Krishna Das Kaviraj lay down to take rest, Lord Nityananda appeared in his dream.
对，就在那天晚上呢，当 Krishna Das Kaviraj 躺下睡觉休息的时候，主 Nityananda 就显在他的梦中显现。
And Lord Nityananda came there, dressed with all in a beautiful turban and beautiful cloth, with a sankirtan party, and they were chanting and dancing. And Lord Nityananda then spoke to Krishna Das and told him, "Don't stay here. Get out of this house. Leave here immediately. Go to Vrindavan."
所以呢，主 Nityananda 在他的梦中显现的时候，主 Nityananda 啊，头上包着漂亮的包头巾，然后他和他所有的同游在那里唱诵啊，然后啊，主 Nityananda 就径直的走到。Krishna Das Kaviraj 面前就对他说不要继续待在这个地方了你应该直接马上就去到 Vrindavan。
So Krishna Das Kaviraj immediately woke up from the dream and he understood that he had been blessed with instructions from Lord Nityananda. So without even waiting for the morning,He immediately left the home in the middle of the night.
所以呢 ，Krishna Das Kaviraj 呢，马上从梦中醒来之后，他意识到他得到了主 Nityananda 的特殊的仁慈，所以他马不停蹄的，甚至没有等到天亮，他就在半夜的时候，他就启程去到了 Vrindavan.
And he got to Vrindavan. He got the shelter of Rupa and Sanatan and Raghunath.And he became a disciple of Raghunath Das Goswami.
所以呢，他去到 Vrindavan 的话，就托庇于 Rupa 和 Sanatan， 并且呢，从 Raghunath Das Goswami 那里得到了他的启迪。
And he wrote the Chaitanya Charitamrita.
于是他就写下了永恒的 Chaitanya 经。
He was able to hear all the pastimes of Lord Chaitanya from the mouth of Raghunath and Rupa and Sanatan.
所以呢，他就能够他就从Raghunath、Rupa 和 Sanatan 那里听到了很多关于主 Chaitanya Mahaprabhu 的逍遥时光，并且把他们记录下来。
So we see the mercy of Lord Nityananda very important.
所以我们可以看到主 Nityananda 的仁慈是如此的重要。
If we want to get the mercy of Lord Nityananda.We have to follow in the footsteps of Lord Nityananda. We have to engage people like Jaghai and Madhai in the service of Krishna.
如果我们想要得到主 Nityananda 的仁慈的话，那么我们就要追随Jaghai 和 Madhai 的步伐，也就是说，我们要去让自己从事于对他人的服务。
So by the mercy of Lord Nityananda, then we can get the mercy of Lord Chaitanya and we can come to understand Radha and Krishna.
借着主 Nityananda 的仁慈呢，我们才能够去理解主 Chaitanya， 然后最终呢达到Radha Krishna 的莲花足。
All right, so we'll stop here. If there are any questions, we'll take any question.
好，那我们今天就讲到这儿了。大家有什么问题吗？你不是有问题吗？
Oh, Maharaj, Maharaj, I'm sorry. I have a question. But you said there is three of the Panchatattva is Vishnu Tattva.
Yes.
Belongs to Vishnu Tattva. And how about the Gadada? What does Gadada belongs to? Which category?Okay, they asked me to translate. 我的问题是刚才那个李新浩的guru 他说那个在五圣体当中三类是属于 Vishnu 范畴的。那我说那个 Gadada 它是属于哪个范畴的呢
？Well, Gadada is manifest the internal potency of the Lord. That's form of
那么 Gadada 呢，它是。它是就是展现的是主的内在的能量是代表了 Srimati Radharani。
So different from Vishnu Tattva. Maybe Shakti, maybe you could say Shakti Tattva.
那么它是和就是 Vishnu Tattva 是不一样的，我们可以把它称为是 Shakti Tattva， 就是主的能量的内在能量的这个真理。
And Srivastakura is the Jiva Tattva.
而 Srivastakura 呢，它代表的是 Jiva Tattva， 也就是个体灵魂，生个体灵魂或者个体生物的这个真理。
So you'll see, we put Tulsi garlands, we put Tulsi on the feet of Chaitanya and Nityananda and Advaita, but not on Gadadhar and Srivas.
Okay. So, 呢，我们可以看到，在五圣体神像的话呢，崇拜的时候呢，我们会把Tulsi叶呢放在主 Chaitanya、Nityananda 和 Advaita 的莲花足上，但是不会放在。就是 Gadadhara 和 Srivas 他们的身上。
We may put Tulsi in the hands of Radharani and or in the hands of Gadadhara to be offered at the lotus feet of Lord Chaitanya.
有时候呢，就是可能会把这个 Tulsi 叶呢放在 Gadadhara 的手中，然后这个意思就是说 ，Gadadhara 会把这片 Tulsi 叶的话，供奉给主 Chaitanya。
Okay.
Thank you, Maharaj. Thank you very much.
Okay, any other question?
还有其他的吗？其他的问题？
Okay, so we won't keep you any longer.
Okay. And do you want me to show you the devotees here? Do you want to have a look or greeting with them?
Oh, you want me to meet the one lady, was it?
Oh, yes. Before the private darshan, do you want to have a look of all the devotees here? Shall we open the camera and they can also see you?
No, it's okay. we haven't changed
but
much.
But I guess... Okay.
I don't think we've changed so much.
Okay. But do you want to see them or...
Yeah, I can see, okay. I can see their names.
Okay, I see. So Maharaj, then the private darshan, maybe we'll arrange on the WeChat. We can directly,
okay,
so that we can get out of the room.
Yeah, you can do that, yeah.
Yeah, then maybe they can continue with Kirtan, some other next program.
Yeah, they should sing, you should sing the songs about Lord Nityananda, just like...
Yes, we will. Yes, we arrange. Yeah, yeah. 好，接下来的话呢，就是我们大家会来做唱诵，然后我们也会唱一些关于主尼提南达的赞歌。那么同时呢，就是我们会有一些个人的安排，好吗？
There's also one song about Lord Nityananda. It says Lord Nityananda never becomes angry.
Oh, Akroda Paramananda Nityanandara. Yes.
Yeah, do you sing that sometimes?
Yeah. Yes, we will.
But of course, we know Lord Nityananda sometimes did get angry.
So, Maharaj 就建议我们可以唱一些关于主尼提南达的歌，然后其中呢是有一首歌呢是讲到了主尼提南达从来不生气，当然在他的下时光当中，有时候他也会生气。
One time he kicked Shivananda Singh.
有一次呢，他踢了 Shivananda Singh.
They were going to Puri, and they had to wait a long time in the hot sun.
那么他们去正在去普里的路上，然后他们在热辣辣的太阳下面在等待。
And they hadn't taken any prasadam.
他们没有容纳任何的 prasad。
So they had, they were waiting. Shivananda Sen had to talk to the people at the border, the customs, as they were coming across the border. Shivananda Sen had to deal with some authorities.
然后呢，他们当时呢是要，嗯，就是说要过一些跨境嘛，要跨境过一些关卡。然后呢，就是大家都在那儿等着，希望那那信呢得去给那些卫兵打交道。
And they were waiting and waiting a long time. The Lord Nityananda became disturbed. It was taking so long.
他们然后他们在那儿等了很久，然后就Nityananda就觉得说，挺受打扰的，因为他们等了很久了。
So at one point, Lord Nityananda cursed. They said, "Let the sons of Shivananda Sen die."
然后就Nityananda他是那么的生气，他就开始诅咒Shivananda Sen说，让Shivananda Sen的儿子死去吧。
And then the wife of Shivananda Sen, she began to cry because she thought, "Oh no, Lord Nityananda is cursing my son to die."
然后Shivananda Sen的妻子就，哎呀，难过的在那儿哭呀，就Nityananda在诅咒我们的儿子去死啊。
And when Shivananda Sen came and he saw his wife crying, he said, "What's wrong?" And she said, "Because Lord Nityananda has cursed our son to die."
然后Shivananda Sen他这个回到他妻子身边的时候，他就问他妻子，哎，你哭什么呀？他说，就Nityananda就揍我们的儿子去死呀，怎么办？
And Lord Shivananda Sen said, "If Lord Nityananda wants our son to die, let him die. Why is that?"
Shivananda Sen 说，哎，如果主Nityananda要我们的儿子去死，那就让他死呀。
And so then Lord Chaitanya came and kicked Shivananda Sen.
然后呢，主Chaitanya就正好。
Thank you so much. Did you hear that? I don't know.
I'm sorry.
I got a disconnect.
Last sentence.
You didn't hear?
We didn't hear the last sentence.
I was saying that Lord Chaitanya, Lord Nityananda came and kicked Shivananda Sen.
Nityananda 就过来踢了 Shivananda Sen 一脚。
And then Shivananda Sen said, "Oh, I'm so fortunate. I've been touched by the dust of your lotus feet. Today my life is successful."
然后 Shivananda Sen 就说了，哦，我太幸运了，我被你的莲花足踢到了，我的生命达到了完美。
So Lord Nityananda was appreciating the very nice surrendered attitude of Shivananda Sen.
所以呢，就Nityananda他非常的欣赏Shivananda Sen这样的一种臣服皈依的心态。
And Shivananda Sen immediately made arrangements for Lord Nityananda to have nice accommodation and have nice prasadam.
所以呢，Shivananda Sen他就马上就给就Nityananda安排了很好的住的地方啦，以及prasadam做出所有的很好的安排。
But usually we would not see Lord Nityananda angry. He would go door to door and knock on people's door, requesting them to chant the holy name.
在通常呢，就是我们不会看到就Nityananda那么容易的生气的。通常他都会挨家挨户的去祈求人们来唱诵圣名。
Lord Nityananda had been told by Lord Chaitanya that he should go door to door and request everyone to chant the holy name and read the books about Krishna and worship Krishna.
所以呢，就Nityananda，就Chaitanya Mahaprabhu要求就Nityananda去挨家挨户的去请求人们唱诵 Krishna 的圣名去崇拜Krishna 去崇拜 Krishna 去追随 Krishna 的教导。
So they would, Lord Nityananda would go and knock on the doors, and sometimes people would come, they'd open the door and see him there, and then they would slam the door in his face.
So, 主尼天南达呢，他就会挨家挨户的去祈求，但是当有时候当人们开门看到是主尼天南达的时候，他马上就把门给关了，给他一个闭门羹。
And Lord Nityananda would fall on the ground and cry.
然后主尼天南达他就会倒在地上，在那儿伤心的哭泣。
You feel great compassion for these fallen souls that they're so unfortunate they won't chant the holy name.
他为这些堕落的灵魂感到遗憾和悲伤因为他们不接受主的圣名。
So Lord Nityananda, he is the personification of the third verse of Shikshastikam, more tolerant than the tree and devoid of all sense of false prestige and ready to offer all respects to others.
So, Lord Nityananda, he is the 八训规的这个关于谦卑的这一个师节的一个人格的代表，也就是说要像草一样谦卑，像树一样宽容，摒弃一切虚荣感，随时向别人致敬。
So on this auspicious day, we're all praying to Lord Nityananda. Please engage us in the service of Sri Chaitanya.
So, in this auspicious day, we're all praying to Lord Nityananda. Please engage us in the service of Sri Chaitanya. So, in this auspicious day, we're all praying to Lord Nityananda. Please
engage us in the service of Sri Chaitanya. So, we wish you all have a nice celebration there today.
我希望大家呢今天都能够有非常棒的一个庆祝。
All right, so thank you for your association.
非常感谢你们的联谊。Singha Maharaj Ki Jai! Nityananda Ki Jai!
不知道呀，不都看得见吗？
Hare Krishna, Hare.